Resort Hotel.
Polynesia is one big South Seas fantasy, featuring tropical gardens, beaches, luau's, and balmy breezes from the lagoon. Disney's Boardwalk Inn captures the essence of a grander time.
Thank you.
of the high-tech life we enjoy today.
Thank you. machine is rotating backward for your return to Earth.
In preparation for your return to Earth, your time machine is now rotating backward.
Thank you. 10.
Hello, and welcome to Soarin. My name is Patrick, and I'll be your chief flight attendant today. We'll begin boarding in a few minutes, but first I'd like to acquaint you with some important safety information. Soarin to tower. We are ready for takeoff.
Thank you.
better than that. Nothing else.
But it's better because it's not really intense. Like, there's not.
Yeah.
I don't think it has been unbearable.
We're just like, we try not to.
I don't trust the county giving me my water.
Wait, wait.
vending machine, and that way make it more clean. Please report the break room immediately.
Sensory lamps, please remain seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside your tour trap. Keep a watchful eye on your children and them.
Enjoy your tour, scientists. Careful with those hats, it's a little windy. Enjoy.
Bienvenidos. Para su seguridad durante su estadía en nuestros laboratorios sensoriales, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del vehículo. Y cuide a los pequeñitos. Gracias.
Special drive-through open house. I'm Dr. Nigel Channing, chairman of the Imagination Institute. Hello. On your tour, you'll see how the five human senses can help capture your imagination.
Oh, can I go too?
I want you out of my sight.
Out of sight? Okay. Come on, everybody. Here we go.
Figment, you are not to interfere with the tour. Our first stop is the sound lab. Your hearing with a series of tones. Left ear, right ear. Left, right. What? This is on. Hello? Who is this?
It's Figment.
Figment? I thought I told you not to interfere.
But you've got it wrong, Doc. It's not about listening with your ears. It's about listening with your imagination.
Now I've completely lost my train of thought.
No, you haven't. Over here! All aboard! Woo-hoo! Next stop, imagination! For every sound your ears are hearing, a thousand thoughts can start appearing, and each of us imagines different things. From just the sound, your mind has wings.
Continuing now, if I may, in a calm, scientific, figment-free manner, the things we see with our eyes can control the eyes of the imagination. But let's begin by using the eye chart to test your vision. Now, all together, please read life three and
with that much you can see things differently. Sure, you can see with your eyes, but imagine what you could see if you used your imagination. Follow the bouncing figment. One spark of light can light your fancy. Your mind sees more than what your eyes see. Your sense of sight can make your fancy fly. There's more to sight than meets the eye. Time to use your imagination, so let the good times roll! Woohoo! You win one cent! Of
much more fun. Right this way, everybody.
Friedman, what is going on? You're turning this entire open house upside down.
Upside down? Now you're talking. That's the best idea you've had all day.
With just the spark of inspiration, I made my house an innovation. Imagination really comes around. Makes downside up and upside down.
Imagination works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc. Imagination is a blast!
Seguridad, permanezca sentado con sus manos y brazos, pies y piernas dentro del parque y cuida a los pequeñitos. A manera de recordatorio, no tomar foto por flash y luz de video antes de llegar a Inglaterra. One of those living systems is the rainforest, home to the most amazing concentration of life on our planet. These dense and beautiful forests cover only a tiny portion of the Earth's surface, but they contain more than half of its plant and animal species. Rainforests are also extremely rich in productive living systems, providing us with oxygen, food, medicines, and other elements essential to our lives. Even the hooves of the mighty buffalo helped create the rich soil, one day become home to the American farm. Of all the forces at work on the land, humans have had one of the most profound effects. The need to produce food for a growing world led to the enormous use and sometimes overuse of the land. In our search for more efficient ways to grow food, we often fail to realize the impact of our methods. Discovering better ways to grow food that will assure both human and environmental well-being.
In Japan, Batman makes leaves and other materials into our soil. We can make farmland grow for without any chemicals. Here at Epcot, we're learning to reduce the need for chemical pesticides by breeding and using natural predators like ladybugs and wasps to control. In the farmlands across America, we're learning that by plowing under vegetation containing natural fertilizers, we can enrich the soil without the use of chemicals. In arid regions, we're learning to produce food on desert seacoast. coasts by developing and planting crops that thrive in saltwater. In Japan, we're learning that by mixing leaves and other living materials into our soil, we can make farmland more
tomorrow's growing needs for food production, yet still respect the needs of the land. Some of the answers are being discovered just ahead. To help us maintain these carefully controlled ecosystems, and for your safety, please remain seated in your boat at all times. Laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests now and into the future. The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. One day, many of these lesser-known tropical plants may be as important as the bananas growing on both sides of the boat. More than 28 million tons of bananas are eaten annually, making it the most popular fruit in the world. Step as you exit.